إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، الحمد لله، all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His help and forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of our souls and from the wickedness of our own deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, none can guide. I bear witness and testify that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His final messenger. As to what follows, my dear brothers in Islam, firstly, I'd like to say that I love you all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I come from Sydney, Australia, all the way here to Kuwait, to remind you and to remind myself about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers in Islam, this dunya, this world, by Allah, it's a deception. Many of us misunderstand this world. Many of us don't understand why we are living. Many of us think that success is in this dunya, subhanAllah. Many of us, subhanAllah, need to understand that this dunya, this world, is like a drug. Many of you now are thinking, what am I talking about? But by Allah, just as a drug gives you a high, but what happens later on? It just comes falling down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us as Muslims, and we have to thank and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night for this blessing. We have to use Islam to get us where? To Jannah, to the heavens. But the deception of this world covers our eyes sometimes. The deception of this dunya, it clouds our eyes and our understanding that we forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I was born and raised in Sydney, and I can see and I saw so many things in my life. But traveling through the Arab lands, I can also see the deception of this dunya here in the Islamic country, subhanAllah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the strength and ability to keep Islam firm in our hearts. We have to understand, as I said, that this world is like a drug, subhanAllah. Many, many, many years ago, as I was growing up, I worked as a security guard, subhanAllah, in one of the shopping centers in Sydney. And we caught some thieves. And we caught them stealing glue, super glue. And this glue had a very, very strong smell, subhanAllah, and I didn't understand. Why would such people steal glue? It's only a few dollars, subhanAllah. And I asked one of my friends, the other security guard, and I said, Ya Akhi, why? Why do they steal this glue for? And he said, Ya Akhi, these people are drug addicts. And it is a cheap hit for them. And it makes them high, it makes them forget. Why do people drink alcohol and take drugs? Because they do not know what they want in this world. They want to lose their mind, they want to forget about their troubles. And unfortunately, the Muslims in this day and age want to also forget. They want to forget their troubles. But let me tell you something, subhanAllah. If you're living life comfortably, check your Islam. Check your Iman, subhanAllah. You know, one of the most blessed companions was Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. This man met the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the last 3 years of the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu live? Do you think he lived a luxurious life? Do you think that he had much wealth? Wallahi, by Allah, he gave up the dunya. He lived in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He lived as a poor man. He gave up the world. He gave up his dunya in search of knowledge, in search of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, he narrates in a hadith, he states that sometimes people used to think that he was crazy. Majnun, people used to think he was crazy. But he said, by Allah, I was not crazy, I was starving. I was hungry. I had no food. He used to sit near the minbar of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he used to recite words of the Quran about giving, about charity. And subhanAllah, Umar radiallahu anhu walks past. And Umar didn't understand what Abu Hurairah was talking about. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu walks past. And Abu Bakr didn't understand. But then we have the Prophet of Mercy, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he walks past. And he understood the pressure that Abu Hurairah was going through, and he said, Ya Abu Hurairah, come with me. Now we're talking about the best of creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of the prophets, the best man to ever walk the face of the earth, subhanAllah. He said, come with me, Ya Abu Hurairah. I will give you something to eat. So Abu Hurairah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, goes home into one of his house, or his wife's houses. And he asked his wife, do we have anything to eat? Now who are we talking about? The leader of humanity. Do we have anything to eat? And I ask all of you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I ask any of you now, how much food do you have inside your homes? Many of you could feed maybe 20 people, 30 people, 50 people. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his wife, do we have anything to eat? What do you think the reply was? She said, we only have enough milk. We only have enough milk for one or two people. Hada Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only enough milk for one or two people. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he saw the cup of milk and he became happy. He became so happy, subhanAllah, because the hurt inside of his stomach was about to go. Now the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to teach Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu a lesson. And he also wanted to teach us a lesson. He said, Ya Abu Hurairah, go and call all Ahl al-Suffa. Go and call all the people, all the poor people living in masjid, in the masjid. Go call them all. And Abu Hurairah, his heart dropped. SubhanAllah, call all of them. There's only one cup of milk. All this time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is smiling at Abu Hurairah. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understood this world. Go and call all of them. And the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were different people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about them, radiallahu anhum wa radu anhum. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. And they could never ever go against the word of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu went. He called all the Safa. And there was a narration that there were many, many, maybe 100 or so. He called them all. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a smile on his face said, Ya Abu Hurairah, let them drink. The first one drank to his full. The second one, the third one, the fourth one, the fifth one, until the last of them drank. And by Allah, there was still milk left in this cup. There was still milk left in this cup. There's a secret ingredient that they had, which was what? Tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Understanding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Abu Hurairah, there's only you and I left. And he said, yes. He said, Ya Abu Hurairah, drink. He drank. He said, Ya Abu Hurairah, drink. He drank. And on the third time, he said, Ya Abu Hurairah, drink. And he drank. And then Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, I can't drink anymore. I can't drink anymore. And by Allah, there was still milk left in that cup. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took the remaining milk and drank it, subhanAllah. This is the blessing and barakah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the people who truly believe in Him. We have so much, but we are deceived by the dunya. We have so much blessings, and that is Islam, and this is all we need by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think that we need houses and mobile phones and beautiful cars to be successful by Allah, the people that are millionaires that don't have Islam, they have nothing. They have nothing. I give you one example of a millionaire living in Sydney. My brother-in-law, he installs kitchens. He's a producer of kitchens. He went to measure and fit a certain job with this millionaire, subhanAllah. And it was an Asian man, and he was a multi-millionaire. So much money, he doesn't know what to do. He said to me, Ya Abu Ahmed, you would not understand. This man had everything. But do you know who he sleeps with at night? I'm thinking, you know, something a bit crazy. He said, Ya Abu Ahmed, this man, he sleeps with a teddy bear dressed in pajamas, a little teddy bear. He sleeps with his teddy bear at night. He has nothing in this world. He has all the wealth. He has all the riches. But he has something lost inside of him. He has something missing inside, which is what? Which is Islam. Which is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is missing from his life. So any of you, my dear brothers in Islam, that are searching for riches, think again because you are a millionaire. Think again because you're a millionaire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has blessed you with Islam. And our millionaire life is not in this dunya. As well in the hereafter in Jannah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My dear brothers in Islam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the heavens and the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He called upon Jibreel alayhi salam, the angel. And he said, Oh Jibreel, go and look at Jannah. Go and look at paradise and what I have prepared for its people. Go look at Jannah. So Jibreel alayhi salam went to see Jannah, to see paradise, this abode for the believers. He saw it and he was amazed. And he was shocked and he came back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, Oh Allah, anyone who hears of Jannah, any person, anyone who hears about Jannah will surely enter it. There's no way in the world anyone that hears about Jannah is not going to work hard to enter it. It's like saying now, my dear brothers, we have $1 million. Anyone who does a certain act, I'm going to give it for him. You're going to run. You're going to work. I want that $1 million. And this is of Jannah, subhanAllah, for the Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put hardships around Jannah as a test to see who is the true believer. To stay away from haram, to pray, to fast, and to do certain acts, subhanAllah. And He said, go and look at Jannah again. Go and have another look, Ya Jibreel. So Jibreel went to see Jannah again, and he came back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said, I fear, Ya Allah, that no one will enter. Unfortunately, we misunderstand worship. Unfortunately, we misunderstand keeping away from haram and doing halal. By Allah, it is something so simple. But us, as human beings, we fall. We sin. We make mistakes from time to time. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Jibreel, go and look at the hellfire. And Jibreel alayhi salam went and looked at the hellfire, and it was layer upon layer. It was a creation that was made to torture. The fire, subhanAllah, the whole fire eats itself. So could you just imagine when a person enters the whole fire, subhanAllah. Jibreel came back, alayhi salam, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said, Ya Allah, anyone that hears about the hell fire will never enter it. Because the aqil, the one who's understanding, who has a great mind, will understand they have to keep away from the hell fire. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put lusts, desires, to see who is going to be a strong believer and who is going to be a disbeliever. And He said, Ya Jibreel, go and have a look. Go and have another look. So Jibreel alayhi salam went to see the hellfire again. And He said, Oh Allah, I fear that so many people will enter. So many people will enter the Jahannam, the hellfire, because of our lusts and desires for the dunya, subhanAllah. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a great blessing in this life. And that is called death. And you may be thinking now at the moment, death is a blessing. I say, yes, death is a blessing. Why? Because it is a reminder. Death is a reminder to you and I. Death reminds us that one day our souls will enter. Our bodies will enter the grave one day. And let me narrate a story to you. It came from one of the people of the Arab land, subhanAllah. He wrote a letter to a shaykh and he said, Ya shaykh, please let me or allow me to tell my story how I came back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, I was a police officer and I used to be a patrolman on the highways. One day we were on the shoulder of this highway and I was sitting with my partner and then all of a sudden we heard a huge bang, a crash. So we looked behind and we had noticed one car had flipped over and gone on the other side and there was another car that was involved in this accident. We rushed to the scene. We quickly went to scene. We got out of our patrol car and we went to the first car. There were two young boys, two young men, in their prime, in their youth, in their strength. They were in the car and they pulled them out very quickly and put them on the side of the road, subhanAllah. They went to the other car and they said the driver of this car had deceased. His soul had left. He had died. So they went back to the other two youth. And they said that these two youth, you could tell the sight of death was there. It was their time to die. So his partner said he had a bit of an experience in helping the deceased say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول. So he started to dictate and to narrate to these young men. قُلُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And this policeman was shocked. What came next? He said, I have never ever witnessed anyone pass away. I have never witnessed anyone die. This was the first time. And I witnessed the first young man starting to sing a song. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sealed this man's lips where he could not say the shahadatayn. He started to sing a song. And the second man started to sing a song. And the other man, the patrolman, his partner, started to plead with them. Please say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Because we know that anyone who dies in the last words, la ilaha illallah, eventually they will end up in Jannah. Through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Slowly, slowly, the two youth passed away. As I mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sealed their lips. They could not say the shahada. They could not say it, but they sang songs because they had evilness in them. They did not have the belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within them. Life went on for this police officer. He said he went back into his normal routine, back to day. Back to his normal life, feeling empty, subhanAllah. And he said 6 months later, he had a new partner and he was on the highway. Another incident happened. They said they saw a young man dressed in a white robe and he had a beard and you could tell he was a religious young boy. They saw and witnessed this young man going to the back of his trunk, of his car to get the tire out as he had a flat tire. Another car came from behind, speeding, and hit this young man. And it smashed into his car, subhanAllah. They quickly rushed. They got this young man, and they said he was full of blood. You could tell that this man's body and his bones were broken in 7 different areas. The patrol officer said we could hear him saying, as we were carrying him into the patrol, car, we could hear him saying certain words, but we didn't take notice at that time. We didn't take notice because of the rush. We put him in the back seat of the car and we quickly rushed to the hospital. They automatically heard him saying these words again in the patrol car. He said, I turned around and I looked at this young man. He said, it looked like he was not even in an accident. His clothes were full of blood. You could tell his eyesight. He was about to lose it in death. The patrol officer said, his police officer said, I could hear the sweetest voice of him reciting the Quran where his hairs stood up. He said, by Allah, I have never heard a sweeter and tender voice like this man. He was reading the Quran and he was lost with the Quran even though he was about to die. And he remembered his partner. He remembered his partner, what he did before. So he looked at this young man and said, قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. And this young man, he stopped reciting the Quran. He lifted up his finger and he said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولَ اللَّهُ. And he passed away. He said, by Allah, I wanted to cry. I looked at my partner and I was so embarrassed. When I looked at my partner, he was crying like a baby, and I also cried like a baby. He said they lost themselves by tears. They have never, ever, ever witnessed anything like this, subhanAllah. They arrived at the hospital, and they called his family, and they wanted to see what was so special about this young boy. What was the special thing about this man? The two men before, Allah sealed their lips so that they could not say the shahadatayn, subhanAllah. What was special about this man? They called his family and his brother came. They said, tell us a bit about your brother. He said, my brother, every single Thursday, he would go out. He would buy things for the orphans, sweets and chocolates and lollies and food. He would have da'wah material to give out, and he would go visit his grandmother every single Thursday to look after her. And that blessed day was a Thursday, and he was on his way to do these blessed acts, subhanAllah. He was out giving da'wah. He was out looking after the poor. He was out calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also he was looking after his family. This young man had an old Mazda, as they said. It was dusty. He didn't have a nice car, but he left with the most richest, the most blessed words that anyone could leave this world with. And that is La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And this is what, my dear brothers in Islam, we have to work to. Forget about the dunya. Yes, we need to live here. We need to eat. We need to sleep. We need to enjoy ourselves in which is halal. But never ever be deceived by the dunya. Never allow the shaitan to deceive you. And if ever, ever you put down your guard, believe me, the shaitan, Iblis, will deceive you. As he deceived our father Adam alayhi salam. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and to give us understanding. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month of Ramadan to increase our iman. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month of Ramadan to give peace amongst all Muslims. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month to give us security in all the Muslim lands and all around the world. Wa aqim as-salam.
الله أكبر.